G'day all, and welcome to a game between myself and Nat playing as the allies, and we are going up against Judska and Shotter. And I just wanted to do more of an analytical approach, I guess. I don't know. I don't think I'm going to commentate as much. I guess I'm going to commentate more on what the players actually buy and what actually happened in this game, because it's actually quite interesting. Is, well, Judska and Shotter haven't lost for quite a while, as you've probably seen. I don't really know how many of their games I'm going to upload, but you'll probably see one or two pop up with a thoroughly crushed, they thoroughly crush Godwin and Nat quite easily. But I'm playing as, once again, the Commonwealth, and I kind of wanted to watch more from the Axis side to just see how they were reacting to things that happened in the game. And I just, you know, wanted to show off some important highlights, I guess. I could have done the cast. I accidentally deleted the Audacity recording myself, so I could have used Nat's voice in here to check it up on the old YouTubes, but I'm pretty sure that no one wants to listen to just Nat's voice as you guys come here. I hope you come here for mine, I guess. At least I hope, because there's 340 of you that are very, very stupid if you're not coming here for my voice. But yeah, I just want to really highlight the power of the Vic. As you can see, that's 4 out of the 5 marksmen are already gone. And that guy was using a direct control to pin him down straight away. But I more wanted to watch the other side of the battle as well, just to see what happened. You see some nice grenade work there from Judska as well. An MG42. I'm pretty sure there was pretty much an MG42 here the whole game. So that'll be something to watch. It was really tough for me and Nat to kill. Actually, we can see him running around there. And Judska did get a rifleman back here. Okay, cool. So they probably were able to see what was going on in our spawn. That might explain a few shots later on. Or does he die? I don't really know. Does he die? No, maybe he doesn't. Not just yet. But there we go. I went with the militia squad. And I was planning, my plan at the start of the game was to go heavy on the right-hand side, because I knew that Judska and Shotter were going to be able to play very, very well if we let them, you know, do what they want. If we just went at the run point and made it a slog, because we were talking, it's snake attack, like, oh no, all the maps are just a slog, blah, 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 blah. And you can see here, I run the Vickers away to bait the BA-20 to come at the Vickers, so the AT rifle gets the kill shot just a little bit easier. And there we go, that worked quite well, I feel. Something that I was pretty happy with. But, as you can see, I've got my Vickers here, or had my Vickers here, and Jessica has his MG42 here, and it just makes the point really, really laney, I guess, in a way. I don't really know if that's the word to describe it, but, you know, like, there's a lane here, and there's a lane of entrance here, and a lane of entrance here. Like, we get this side of the hill to enter from, they get this part where they can hide from, but then there's just open lanes really streaming in the middle. So, with those machine guns, it really cut off the avenues of attack, I guess. And, I'm probably going to try and explain some of the decisions I made whilst I was playing as well. We can see here, a little grenade. I also bought an assault squad, so I think I went Vickers, militiaman, AT rifle for the BA, for that little BA-20, and then an assault squad, because I really sensed an opportunity to go hard at Shotter. I really sensed that, look, I had already lost 2 SMG guys, and I saw, what, there's 3 SMG guys there. I knew that already, and I was thinking, well, I can probably try and exploit the early BA-20 buy and get through that side a little bit easier than I could on other flanks. But you can see that MG42 still there, still firing. My Vickers is dead right now. I think, yes, my Vickers did die eventually. I'm not sure where it died, but I'm pretty sure it did somewhere, or I might have moved it somewhere else. I don't really know, but there's a truck with a flak here from Godwin as the flamethrower. I might actually track this flamethrower, because I believe this might be the one that does some damage, and I really want to show off, exemplify the brilliance of Judska's flamethrower play, because I used to love them. Like, I used to love, you know, running into a bunch of soldiers and being able to time it well. But I think Judska's taken it to a next level, and Shotter also, and those guys are really, really good at and actually using the flamethrower effectively, really. But we'll see him move over in a bit, I think. And we'll see what I'm talking about. But unfortunately, that EM3 rifle grenade shot there missed. I've got an assault squad coming. I don't think I brought my first hero point too quickly. I might have brought a Blackwatch squad a little bit late. But you can see the flamethrower here. You see, Shotter's in a bit of trouble. I've got my infantry up in the hills. I'm also getting away around here. But you can see he's just run the flamethrower over. And by doing that, he's really stopped me being able to run up this zone. And it's done really well. I was quite surprised when I saw the flamethrower of all units come across and help. You can see Nat and Judska pretty much set up like this and stay like this the whole game. We can see that a few MGs are left. It's pretty much just, it's just going to stay like this the rest of the game. Nothing too exciting happens over on this side of the map, except some stuff later on, but you guys will see that in due time, I'm sure. But Judska also rolling up with a Panzer N. which was a good buy, I guess. They were down 16-0, and they needed to start building up and score some cover. There's my Vickers, actually. I have 8 kills, and Jodska has, oh, that's might be where he got, only has 2, so the Vickers was doing a lot better, but, you know, the Vickers did catch the Marksman squad out in the open early on. But here I went with a Grenadier unit. It's the 1-point hero unit. It comes with 4 Grenadiers, I believe, and this is where I was really able to start hurting. I targeted that flamethrower instantly, and the Marksman Jaegers were here as well. And this is where I was really able to start pushing him and start hurting him a little bit, as they were both focusing on that center a lot more than what they probably should have. That flak being unmanned for so long was a very surprising thing. Is Nat 9, you can see he bought the BT-7A. I'm throwing grenades at it, trying to shoot with a rifle grenade. The marksman Jaegers were cleaned up, I think, by a rifle grenade over here as well. And you can see the flak trying to pin down some of my soldiers. And for some reason, that was not killing it. Even though the shells were landing right behind it, and then grenade got those guys off again. But you can see the end just sitting there from Judsko. I think that might be in direct control, or he might be using it. There's also a veteran sniper out from Judsko, which was doing some work. My guy's got 8 kills. Judsko's machine gun still only has 2. And, yeah, it was pretty interesting. But he was able to hold off that assault, I guess. He had 2 marksman Jaegers. Yeah, left. I lost a Grenadier squad. I was pretty angry that I lost the whole Grenadier squad, really. Even though that guy was alive, he had a Molotov landed on his face. But yeah, I was pretty disappointed that I lost that kind of first spot, I guess. You can see the BT-7A in the end about to go to work and create the grind fest. But we're up 0-24 at the moment. And Nat was saying that maybe we should, you know, just lock down and hold the middle. And I was saying, man, don't worry about that, as the Vickers might be about to die. I said, don't worry about that, man. I'm just going to go all out at this right-hand side. And I got Militia, Anzacs, and then I also went and bought myself another Grenadier squad, I believe. Yes. So I spent three hero points, bought myself a P-8 for any vehicles, and went with that Anzac squad. So this was really my way of trying to change the momentum of the game. And we'll see how I went. I don't know if I went too well or not, but we'll see. The MG there is only got 2 kills, and the Vickers, I decided to move into the road. He's got 11 kills at the moment, but this really wasn't an effective firing position. You can actually use this as cover, but they can shoot through the holes that's in the cover, so it's not really that effective. So I was trying to put a sandbag, didn't really place it where I wanted it to. We can see over here that my AN3 rifle grenade is working well over in the top left hand corner. This is what I wasn't expecting. I don't think I'd seen this yet, and I'd ran up some Anzacs, which unfortunately were all killed. If I knew that, I would have used the Grenadier squad a hell of a lot earlier, and I would have made sure that this thing was down before I even tried to enter the ice. Like, that was a big mistake on my part there, not scouting out what was going on. But we can see the BT-7A hitting some things down there. And I just decided to F1 spam, or I actually have it as mouse button 3 spam on my mouse now. So there you go. I used the AM3 rifle grenade to take out the MG, but then Shota has a flamethrower, and I knew it was going to be tough trying to attack up this little lip, but that flamethrower really did a lot of damage here. Got the whole militia squad pretty much, and some important guys, but the main guy was still alive, and that was the machine gunner. He was the one that I was trying to bank my assault off. You can see him there, he gets the kill on the Anzac soldier, and he's right here, the White Death guy. He's got 4 kills, and unfortunately, I believe he gets away in the end. But I also decided to back up my assault. I was like, well, if I'm going to make the first push, I may as well make another. I went and bought an elite SAS squad, got some militiamen, also bought a Crusader AA to get over here, and I thought that this was my time to go, which is really it, where I have to start pushing hard. And you can see that I was. Crusader AA cleans up the troops. We'll just have a look back at the middle. There was nothing too exciting going on. I think I bought a flamethrower. No, that was that's Nat's. That's a Soviet flamethrower. So he was just, we pretty much said, look, I pretty much told him, you look down the middle, and I'm just going to go hard at this right-hand side and get as many points as we can, you know, before Judsko and Shota start taking over the game. Because we knew it was inevitable. I'd say they're probably the team to beat of the tournament, and they're much better than us at the moment, I'd say. They're probably a little bit better than us at the moment. But you can see there, I take out that guy. Luckily enough, the Grenadier of the Assault Squad comes in as well, and I also hired a P-8 somewhere up here, which is going to become important later on. There we go, there's the P-8. I was remembering, he hired somewhere up there, which helps me a lot later on. The Panzer N moves across as well. Probably should have spread these guys out a lot earlier, but I was doing a lot of things. I was trying to get guys in buildings, trying to get guys all around corners and stuff like that for ambushes, so it was probably not microing my greatest over here, but I got the Assault Squad leader into a position where I think It was quite handy. Yeah, there we go. I think I probably should have put him back around here a little bit. But the response from Shotto was I guess, paratrooper squad. They're called something Jaegers, but I'm pretty sure they're like 3rd tier infantry. They're not the border Jaegers, so I'm pretty sure they're like the German paratrooper equivalent. But the Crusader AA was really my big ticket item. I'd saved a little bit for it, and this was what I decided was going to win me this side and keep this side as long as I can. So you can see there, 10 minutes 10. It was 32-0, I just capped the point. So you can see that eventually, if or when I lose it, you can see how many points we eventually get from having the snide. You can see now I was going to just play some games of the Panzer F. All my goal was to just keep this point as long as I could and kill as much infantry as I could and take pretty much the Titanic sinking, and I'm taking as many down as I with it. That sounds really like narcissistic and evil and almost Hitler-like, but I'm just trying to take down as many people as I can on the ship with me. So I position the Crusader AA and, you know, make sure I can see these reservists over here. Unfortunately, they weren't the Jaeger squad. This is what I thought I was hitting. I thought I was getting the big Jaeger guys, which plays a bit favourable in the Shotter's hands later on when he takes back the point. I think the Crusader AA decided, look, I've got to run it, and I've got to draw him in towards the P-Out, and we'll see. The P-Out man gets up, shoots over the fence, and easily takes out the Panzer F, even though this was just stunned, so very unlucky that he didn't actually die. But hey, some luck went against Shotter, which doesn't happen all the time. I was trying to kill the half-truck as quick as I could, but unfortunately got away, and then I had to try and kill as many soldiers as I could. But unfortunately that did not work for me either. So the full paratrooper squad and pretty much the Jaegers are sitting over here. But Jalska pulls out pretty smartly. You know, gets his guys over here. He could use them in another area in that nap. There's only been 1 minute 20 and we've already gained 11 points off me having this this little bit of an advantage. But I blew P out there, just, you know, positioning him to if the half-track ever comes back. Now this is where it gets interesting, because Jutsu is very good at using the end to actually kill the lightly armored tanks, and unfortunately he gets my track, and I'm in a lot of trouble here, as you can see. I don't know if you can see how far that is away, but it's like 120 meters and he's just going to pop off a few shells, and I really don't have the best of my armor facing him. You can see I've been double tracked and probably will be engine damaged soon, I can't really remember. But I was also noticed this. Shotter was trying to get a Panzer Shrek off of me, it wasn't going to let that happen, made sure I destroyed the guy, so there was no chance that was happening. Then I went down, but you know, I saved myself there from the eventual Panzer Shrek. 0-50 pretty much at the moment, so that is 2 minutes and 20 seconds, and we gained about 18 points. So at the moment it was definitely paying off for us. We can see the half track rush to the middle, but the T-60 there takes it out, and we're going to see some more end shenanigans, I believe, as we'll watch this side of the battle for, you know, for a few seconds. These are looking annoying as bloody, indirect support HMGs, or whatever they are. But the T-60 unfortunately does die. That was a bit of a letdown. But I probably decided this too late. I think I had about 400 manpower. I could probably check. Hopefully the game doesn't crash. But yeah, I had a decent amount of manpower just before this moment. Unfortunately, I didn't switch over earlier. But running the rifleman over there back is something I always do, trying to keep him alive as long as I can. But this half track probably could have been bought 30 seconds earlier, and I would have been here earlier. The Panzer aim was already trying to kill the T-60, so that was really out of sight. And the whirlwind in the background we didn't know about yet. So yeah, I was in the clear pretty much in there to hold on at this point if I decided to charge the half track just a little bit earlier. I also bought an SAS squad because I decided that I really needed some big guys in here. I went with the SAS soldier to try and kill the White Death that was around here in the machine gun. And unfortunately, it actually bounced off this part of the wall and didn't, the explosion damage didn't do anything. But the half track went down pretty easily, I'd say. I bought the SAS squad just for the Vickers, man. Like, he's got 8 kills. This Mr. Vickers is still alive. He's got 12. He's run out of ammo, though, and I couldn't really resupply him, so I think I just charged him in somewhere in the end. But the whirlwind comes across, makes life hell for me. As you can imagine, it's done a bit of damage so far. At least it's captured back a point for them. But I decided to buy a Churchill Crocodile. Most people in the tournament probably won't be doing this. The Churchill Crocodile isn't the greatest unit to get. It's very situational. I was thinking that I would kill the Whirlwind and then be able to reposition it around here at the middle, you know, so we just had It's like a 35 meter flamethrower off the ridge, and also had pretty much a tank that was going to eat shells so I could keep HE shelling their cover and hopefully find myself a sniper kill. But it's not the way it went down. I got this guy on hold fire actually to try and get him away, but then I ran him. If I kept him down, probably would have gone a little bit better for him. But the PT-7A from NatNat comes over to save the day. Fortunately, it's probably going to miss a few shells. I don't think it gets too lucky in the ability to track or anything. I tried the AT rifle. I wonder if I actually damaged this at all. I didn't know in the game. I tried to get the turret or the main gun, maybe some crew guys out of the area, and he has two in there at the moment, which means he can't reload and shoot his MG at the same time, which is good for me. If I tracked him here, that would have been handy. The crocodile, it's a little bit slow, comes into view about now at the world window. We'll see him back off pretty damn quickly from memory, but for some reason, that guy went into a AP grenade, and if he threw the AT grenade the first time, the whirlwind probably would have been dead and would have caused a lot less headaches. But back in the middle, Jutska, you know, trying his sneaky little tracking maneuvers on my crocodile. I knew that I had to get the crocodile as close as I could, but I decided to juke it out a little bit with the M. You know, I tried some fire shooting off the object here, but it didn't go well for me, as I knew that I needed to pretty much take one shot at the whirlwind, try and track it, which I did just there, and then focus my attention on the end, because it was showing a little bit of side armor. Probably wasn't going to show too much more, but our NatNat's T-34-57 could have done well if it was moved to the road, I reckon, because you know he has a bit of a shot through there, but didn't take it, unfortunately, which, you know, everyone makes mistakes. I went with another SAS squad, just the elite infantry, because I knew that there was a paratrooper squad and the Jaeger squad from before that was obviously massing the elite infantry over on this side from Jutska and from Shotter as well. So I knew that I had to get some heavy hitters if I was going to be able to capture the point. What is this? This is another half-track by here, another paratrooper squad, I think, from Jutska. And then the BT-42 light tank, which I think I kill by fire shooting through a tree. Yes, I actually have this game recorded whilst we're playing on Shadow Play, so if anyone, you know, says, well, you fire shot it, I can actually prove that I fire shot it through the objects, which is allowed, which I voted for in the little vote we had before the tournament. But so anyway, back onto the action, not more of the bickering. The crocodile sets up, and I was hoping that I would actually do a little bit more damage to the whirlwind than what I did. I was actually kind of hoping to finish it off, but I didn't, and I kind of want to switch back to this side to watch Shot of Manpower just for a little bit. But as you can see, Shotter, you know, shooting off these ridiculously overpowered HE shells worth 10 to 9. I'm pretty sure the veterinary artillery has some overpowered HE shells, etc., etc. HE shell has become much more predominant in, the gameplay recently. You can see me, I unfortunately land short and hit the ground instead of going for the tree, which, you know, wasn't ideal, but T-34-57, keep in the middle of the bay, paratroopers now running around, STG-44 there as well, the paratroopers I'm pretty sure will be able to cut the middle quite easily. Nat, you know, not doing much, he was just doing what I asked, he was just holding the point, you know, I was just going everything it shot at, you know, so we could keep them separated. It was 4 to 69, I forgot to mention how many points that we got when we lost that backflag, but I'm pretty sure it was around 69, so we probably gained about 30 points for about 2 minutes hard work. But I did hull damage and engine damage. That's why I wanted to watch it, because in our game, I don't think we had these. We didn't have the message on, or I couldn't see the messages when it was hull damage, so that was a little bit unfortunate for me, probably because it was away in the shadows when it was engaging me, so I could only see it just when it shoot. Main gun turret and track on the whirlwind was good, just keeping it there so I could keep shooting it. He has a lot of reserve soldiers, with the Panzerfaust there actually, which is quite interesting. But there you go, Shotter bought the veteran Arty. I'm pretty sure he bought it for Jutska in the end. I'm pretty sure Jutska uses it, I don't know, we'll see in a sec. But there you go, there's another brilliant machine gun placement from Jutska, and he's also got another one sitting here, which they become really annoying. Those, what is it, FG-42s? Yeah, they became really, really annoying later on in the game. But the guard sniper, he did buy the guard sniper, they both got picked off by, the White Death. So then he bought his own sniper, you know, just to keep it back. If you ever get a sneaky shot at the White Death, you should probably take it. Veteran sniper here only had 4 kills from Jutska. I guess both players knew that the other had a sniper and weren't really going to do anything too amazing about it. But the PAT for me, put him in here, you know, to get off some PAT shots on the hill to kill these soldiers without really having to do did too much legwork. And this is the Vickers guy. This is the guy with 13 kills, paid for himself in the early game. I just charged him in, and I think I laid him down, but, you know, he's not laying down at the moment. Just to keep the point, just to keep the point in our... So just trying to decap the point. I wasn't really trying to capture it. Just wanted to try and take as much time and as many points off them as we could. But unfortunately... Oh, I did get the SAS for in time. Yeah, I was just about to say, I thought I didn't get the SAS for in time. And then just when I was about to catch the middle... Nat goes and drops a BM8-24 round right onto my infantry. You know, if he hit around here, it would have been glorious because we would have got that MG, possibly the veteran sniper, and then could have been able to rush his side if we had infantry. But our communication was a little bit off there, unfortunately. I got tracked by the stupid veteran arty, which I hate it so much. I hate the idea of an artillery unit being able to just, you know, kill a tank straight away, and especially the veteran arty. I found out that when it ties its second round, pretty much its second round, like every round lands exactly where you want it to, kind of thing, because you can fire at the same place twice or something like that. I can't remember, but you know, that's pretty much, you'll see the accuracy on that. It's just ridiculous. And to have the ability to track the clock, and I'm pretty sure it ends up engine damaging, it's double tracking, and the turret's down as well. I think I killed off the World One. Yes, I did, it's burning, and that is being given up on, so. That was interesting, but yeah, it's just really bullshit. I hate the veteran artillery unit as a unit in the mod, but you know, it'll probably be around for the tournament. We captured back the middle, which was quite handy, and we led 69-12 at this point, and I pretty much told Matt that now's go time, really. They got the veteran arty, so that was a little bit of CP, even though they can buy an officer, you know, and get that CP boost, but you know, I thought that this was time. This was our time to shine. We really had to hold into this middle point as long as we could. So he went with the T-60 and rushed towards middle. Can't remember what this died from in the end, but so I bought that, and also Jessica bought a Nash one, which is going to become, you know, it's going to become more, I guess, relatable. Not relatable. It's going to show its colours a little bit later in the game. But the reserve squad here from Shotto moving in on the middle, knew where my SAS guy was, threw a Molotov at him, get him out of the hole, and then, you know, pin him down with the machine guns and eventually kill him, I'm pretty sure. But Shraddy's asking me if I'm on at the moment. I should probably try and record him, but I won't right now because that would be a little bit of an interruption. That would involve bringing up the steam overlay, but I was turret and engine damaged, and the thing reloads and fires so quick I could never get it prepared. Look at that, it's literally landing on top of my tank every single time. The accuracy was amazing, but there you go, that's the engine damage. That's what I was pissed off at. That really annoyed me, that part. But let's go back to my man see my thought process, because I can't really remember what I did from this stage on, to be honest. I think I ended up, I don't even know, I think I went with infantry, no idea, but we'll see. So the middle was a slugfest, really. The flamethrower there from Judska was a very, very good buy. I think that's Judska's one, it might be Shaw's, I'm not 100% sure, but I'd pretty much given up over on this side. I had a grenadier squad, you know, and had one guy down here just to stop any rushes, but I was like, look, it's pretty much over. Got a Vickers guy, sat in there. Actually, there's two Vickers guys, so one must be from the inside squad, one must be from the elite and G squad. Pretty much just sat in there and said, look, we're just gonna time this one out and, you know, not really have another go, because I didn't think it was going to be financially viable, I guess. I only had, you know, about 500, 600 manpower that was going to tick back quickly enough, so I bought an SAS squad and decided that we'd focus on the middle. Those two Vickers guys were going to be important, but I don't think they got the job done. I've actually got three Vickers out at the moment, so plus this SAS squad makes it five. So I was really going for a massive amount of like firepower. I was going like MGs, because I knew they had the MG42, MG34, etc. Those FG42s were up. So I just decided that I'm going to go really, really strong on the Vickers. But there you go, there's a veteran arty, you know, just ridiculous and accurate. The two shells landed there and there and there. So that's in this box. Every shell lands within this box. There's another shell that lands within that box. And no more shells that land within that box. But, you know, it's a bit annoying. And I'll probably point that out a few more times as the video goes on. You guys are probably sick of it already. But the Piat man was in here to kill off some soldiers. Don't think he does. Oh no, he gets one up there, but yeah, I don't think he does, but I'm really going to watch this T-34-57 and this Nash one, because I do some fire shooting a little bit later on that we're going to watch, and I'm going to watch it as well, that Judska and Shotto got very upset about, even though they fire shoot all the time, but whatever, it happens, it's a game, we'll get over it. I don't know if it's going to be in the tournament or not, but Shotto and Judska are definitely the two, probably once again, two of the best fast shooters in the game at the moment. Probably say Shotter's probably the best, and Jutsky's a very close second. So they're going to be a very formidable team. The flamethrower here, the flamethrower work from Shotter was good. Just trying to burn off these guys, so he didn't have any sight over there. But 16-74. BM8 hadn't fired in a while, I believe, and that was a little bit disappointing. But yeah, I moved the T-34-57 around. I'm trying to fast shot through the buildings. That doesn't really work too well. And as you can see, my cover's completely destroyed, so I just hot-tail and get right out of there. He track damages me as well on a very bad angle for me, and I think he backs out and tries to move around to here, which is, you know, is a good idea. So I just jump out of my tank and start jamming straight away, because I really do not want to lose that T-34-57, because I think we have two, and we only have one. I really wasn't down for losing it. I only have 9 CP. I'm pretty sure I've got my officer. Yeah, I do, but only 9 CP, even when you've got the officer on the field, is pretty putrid at the moment. 19-74. It was 55 points of difference, and I had my Vickers up here, and you can see I learned the hard lesson that they can just shoot through the cover, so it was really ineffective. But I put out a sandbag across here, would have been a little bit better. That guy does have 6 kills, though. This guy has none, unfortunately, but he's doing the job. He's, you know, killing on that comes through there, or he's not at the moment, but he should be. This Vickers guy has 1, and this Vickers guy has 5, so I've got, like, I don't know, 5, 7, I think it's like 13 kills out of 4 Vickers guys. That's 3 guys each. It's not really paying for itself, but at least it's providing some covering, providing some pin down. I might actually have a look at the results after the game and see how effective my Vickers were, because I'm pretty sure there's, like, there's a section where you can see, like, Vickers gunners. You see how many you got. You can see Jutsky here is about 180 meters away, 190 meters away. I'm okay with being shot with an object. You know what happens. It's quite a skillful thing. I believe it should be in the game, but if it wasn't in the game, I'd be happy for it. You know, like if the shell dropped off after a certain amount of meters, I'd be happy. Like after its full range, the Nash one is 150, for example. If that's, I don't know, penetration value just went to 0 after a certain amount of time, I'd be pretty happy with that. Watch the middle slog for a little bit longer, I guess. It's nothing too exciting. They eventually take out this Vickers man, who got like 16 kills I saw there. I wish I could rewind these replays. That's an unfortunate feature that they don't have DMS, but I wish I could rewind to check the amount of kills that Vickers man had. The indirect support man. I'm sorry, is it the indirect support man? Yes, it is. I think that's the one that shoots up, is it? No, it's the Maxim machine gun. Wow. That's quite interesting, but he's got that on the middle, and they had the middle at the moment, and that and I were talking, I had 450 manpower. We're talking about what we're going to do, but we're a little bit stuck right now, you know, and we're kind of wondering what we're going to do, but there you go, that's the shot that I took. Unfortunately, I didn't really watch it too well, but it was about 190 meters, and I shot through this outhouse that was there. I should probably add in a screenshot. Where the hell was that outhouse? I'm pretty sure it was like right. Yeah, there you go. That little pile of sticks there. Saw it earlier in the recording, or in the replay, I guess. But yeah, I fast through that that exact bit, object and end up engine damaging the Nashorn. Sorry, hull damaging the Nashorn. And Judsko was pretty unhappy about that for reasons that I guess he's unhappy for it, because we didn't say we were fast shooting or something, but you know, like. They were fire shooting all the other games, and I came and played, and, oh well, whatever, shit happened. But the flamethrower now on the middle was locking down the center point quite well. So I went with the Crusader AA as soon as I killed the Nashorn. I'm pretty sure we finish off the Nashorn pretty soon, as Nat gets the end, and then he gets the Nashorn. So I had the Crusader AA, and this was the time where we knew it was go time. So I just ran the Crusader around, you know, try to pick up as many souls as I could. Didn't really care if it died. I got 12 guys here, so I had a squad in a bit. The engine damage there, then I got those two guys, I think. No, maybe I only got the one. I was trying to finish off as many souls as I could whilst rushing the middle. So the assault squad there went into the middle of the T-60 as well, doing the damage. It was 7-4, really required 25 points left, and the Nashorn kill was really our lucky break. The BT, whatever it was, has been repaired and moved over here. The Veterinati actually ends up getting the BMA rocket artillery, which, you know, is interesting. I guess if you could say it's interesting, but the Panzer F also rolling up, trying to see what it can do, prove some shenanigans. But no, I moved the T-34-57 up in response. For some reason, I couldn't get through that wall, which is really weird. You know, it's just a regular stone wall, and you can see all these fucking ones around here, but for some reason, I couldn't get through it. I don't know if I didn't have enough momentum or anything like that, but that was a bit frustrating. Probably won't be fixed, because I don't think the makers of this map play anymore, unless it was Thompson. But I also bought another Vickers machine gun. You can see me spam him out like crazy in every single video that I play. This guy has 5, this guy still only has 1, but they locked down the point quite well, so I was pretty happy with it. Put him straight behind there. I knew there was a sniper over somewhere that we hadn't killed yet, but I knew that the Nash on the end down, I was going to be pretty safe to just plant him there the rest of the game. Paratrooper, FG-42 versus Vickers. That paratrooper's been alive for quite a while, longer than my Vickers. It only just came out. But you see Judska moving the veteran sniper into position. I wonder if he does actually get the Vickers first time. I'm pretty sure he's going for it. 111 meters away. I'm pretty sure the veteran sniper only has 100 range, but oh, well, I guess he was moving it over here to... I guess he was moving it over here to, you know, kill the guys in the middle. I'm just going to take a quick sip of water. I'm very sorry about that. I don't like to do those kind of things whilst I'm talking, but, you know, it's pretty laid back. I haven't been taking this game too seriously on the commentary standpoint at the moment. The Vickers did get pinned down a little bit. He had 4 kills, and the FG-42 still had 6. So he was winning in that battle, I guess. There was a Panzer H also bought from Jadzka. I can't remember what happens to the Panzer H, so this is going to be, this isn't muscle memory, this is just whatever happens, happens. But we can see there Judska rolling up. I think I actually fast-shred him off the bridge, but we'll see in a sec. Nat-Nat backing his T-34-57 out. Impressive. Nat-Nat bought two T-34-57s. He asked me if he was going to buy an ISU-122 or whatever, but I was like, man, don't do that. That's a very silly idea, because they didn't have a Tiger or anything. So here we go. The H is over there. I line it up, I think, with the T-34-57. I was trying to line up across these balustrades, across the pillars on the bridge. I didn't know if you could fast shoot through them or not, and when I found out, I was like, hell yeah. This is the advantage, really. Judska, you know, positioning his tank quite well. I got the T-34-57 shooting at him. He backs off when he realizes, I think, maybe he doesn't back off. And I eventually just track him in a very good position, and that allows Nat-Nat to, you know, back out and move around and take a side shot, which is a pretty good thing for us, I think. We'll see if he does. I'm pretty sure he does pop around the side of the building and finish him off quite easily. Yes, he's at a bit of an angle, but, you know, now Nat-Nat's got him, like, pretty much face on. He bounces a shot miraculously, and then Nat-Nat decides to finish him off anytime soon. There we go. I believe that is Nat-Nat's T-34-57 finishing him off there. The militia squad on the middle is 36-82. At this point, it was pretty much damn done. The main reason that I stopped this is because I'm pretty sure that they closed the game kind of soon. I can't remember who was hosting. I think it was Judska or Shotta. You can see the stats there. I'll show the stats just quickly. And there you go. There is actually, in fact, the end of the game. So what we'll do here is we'll go through the units and see... Is it history? Oh, is it units? Oh, there's no comparison, is there? Is there no effectiveness? Oh, damn, this screen doesn't have, like, the units effectiveness, because I was going to try and see the effectiveness of the Vickers. But anyway, there you go. You can view my buy list if you want. But yeah, they did end up closing the game because it was pretty much game over. Unfortunately, they did know I was recording. But anyway, yeah, GG to Judska and Shotta. And I was pretty happy for me and Nat-Nat to beat him, actually, in a 33-minute game. I wasn't really expecting much. But no, we did well, and I'll catch you guys all next time. Thanks for watching.